Welcome to ILTV's Evening Update. I'm Deborah Blum, here with the latest news from Israel.
Israel's border with Lebanon has been relatively quiet since the Second Lebanon War 10 years ago, but the IDF is bolstering its defenses along the border. In preparing for a possible war with Hezbollah, Israel has expanded its network of fences and surveillance capabilities. Today, tensions were tested when bullets struck an IDF post on the Lebanese border. The army is investigating the shooting, which perforated a soldier's dog tag, but thankfully didn't hurt him. Thus far, it's been deemed that it's just a case of stray gunfire. Despite protests and victim outrage, the parole board is meeting again today to reconsider early release of the former Israeli president and convicted rapist Moshe Katsav. The former president, who's served 5 years so far, hasn't admitted to the sex crimes, expressed remorse for his actions, or participated in any of his prison's rehabilitation programs. This caused him to lose his prior request this year for early release. Since then, Katsav changed his tune ever so slightly by agreeing to the parole board's proposed terms of his release. Israeli involvement is suspected but not confirmed in an airstrike carried out near the Syrian side of the Golan Heights today. It's claimed that an Israeli jet hit a Syrian army post in the border town of Kunetera. It's not immediately clear what the target of the strike was, but increased fighting has been reported in the area. With just a few clicks on your touch phone screen, Get Taxi makes getting a taxi in many parts of Israel as easy as can be. Outside of Israel, Uber and a slew of similar companies have created a transportation revolution that goes beyond what's offered in the Holy Land, as regular drivers use their everyday cars as cabs. Israel's law forbids this, but it's now catching up to the cab sharing offered abroad, which slashes prices. Israel's railways and the Get Taxi app are teaming up to match commuters together to save money servicing destinations to or from Israel's railways' networks of stations.
That's all for now. Stay tuned on ILTV.tv for our main daily broadcast playing after this. I'm Deborah Blum, and see you tomorrow with our morning briefing from Israel at 8 a.m. Eastern Time.